there, my electrical listeners of the gaming community. I do so hope that you're having the finest of evenings and are ready to kick back, relax with the great fantasticness of treats and kick some tiny buns. Welcome one and welcome all to another episode of Survival of the Crafters. I am your host, Ian Kelly, little guy right in front of you. Wah! With the wood. Today we're working a little bit more on the hotel. I'm going to show you where we left off, which was inside of that little man cave. I did some designing inside of the hallway, filling it out a little bit better. We got a couple villagers inside of here that we have swarmed inside. This guy just hides inside of the corner. He looks at me, you know, he's on the bed, he looks at me. Soon he'll be bouncing up and down with the latest patch and so excited. There's two other villagers somewhere throughout this particular place. This room's not finished, it's just a little room with a little branch inside of the corner. Very fantastic, you know, it's very designed, very well thought out. The room over here, which should be the washroom, is not a washroom. It is a little tiny little square room that we'll rent out for maybe $1 a night. That room inside of there, we've already been. This one has crops inside of it. We're not really sure why, so bear with us there. When we open up inside of here, here's the place that we left off last time. We added some red carpet to make you feel extra special. We designed with some waterfalls, some jungle planks, jungle wood on the side, a couple glowstones in the back, some spruce in the very back, and then we got a blacksmith who he's holding his hands very close together and praying because he's so happy that he gets to stay here for the night. He was actually doing Kumbaya in between episodes, so
Kumbaya, my lord.
So we put some shelving on the sides right over here, and on both sides. We got a couple crafting tables in the side over there and a couple ovens over there, which is our furnaces. On the other side of the hotel, I know we promised you that Mrs. Troyer was going to be building the other side of the hotel room.
I'm going to.
She has not currently got to it, but she has been very busy, as you can hear inside of the back. We added the sign that says penthouse suite up this way. I was actually thinking that it's no longer going to be the penthouse suite once we started working on it. It's more like a restaurant. So I was actually thinking of maybe turning it into a restaurant to where we have some seats on the side, a couple tables all over the place. It's more like a lounge at the top of the hotel that people go to. I think that might actually work out a little bit better. And then we work our way one more floor up. And hello, camera. Hello, Ace from camera. So I was thinking maybe build one more layer somewhere along the lines up, maybe going that way and up towards the rooftop.
Look up.
What? Yes, I know. Everyone.
Panties!
Everybody likes seeing your panties. We're very stoked. So there's our other villager who is chilling along the side here. We put some waterfalls.
Oh, this looks pretty cool.
As one of the walls. What?
This waterfall.
Waterfall is pretty cool, huh?
Although I can see the cobblestone.
It's not done.
Oh my god.
So we added waterfalls all along the wall over here. We're going to mix it with a little bit of wood on the top. We put some slabs up there. We aligned each one of the waterfalls with a glowstone. And here I put spruce wood as each one of the logs because I wanted to give it that cabin-ish kind of feel. So I added it as poles in the middle of the room. And here's our waterfall inside the middle. Yes, I know you could still see the stone on the outside over there. And up top, you could still see the stone up there over there. Right now, I'm just getting the room building done. I'm getting the design work out of the way. So we cleaned out the room. We started filling it up. And we'll be taking piece by piece back down as we get a little bit closer in. So right now, what I have inside of my hands is some more slabs, which we are gonna finish with these tops right here. I am aligning the outside edge of each one of our pillars with the wooden spruce slabs. Cause that's what we're doing right now. Ace wanted everyone to know that he said hello. So just know that I put him in there for that. And probably the rest of that will be regular slabs. Just a guess, but maybe not. So I'll fill it out rough. I'm being attacked! Mosquitoes! So I went ahead and filled that out. That looks good already. Looks cool. And we shall fill out this. We got a couple poles that's left here. On the outside right there. And we do have a couple newcomers to the series. One of them, I believe, does a YouTube series himself.
Who's that?
Boy Captain. Boy, it's yo Captain! So we're going to go ahead and call him Captain. Because we don't want to say, boy, it's your captain. Instead, we're going to say, captain. So he will be the captain of Crunch. I think that does him very well. So let's outline this, outside align this with a little bit of wood to, oh, what? We ran out. To the crafting table! Okay, so we made it over there. Let's make some more slabs. Okay, which we have done. We've saved some more planks for ourselves. Let's align the outside edge. Now, I build this really slow because I like giving a lot into each room. And sometimes it's a little bit too much. But to me, I like a lot going on inside of rooms. And so far, that is looking beautiful. As I circle around that and it has the wood on the outside, that looks really nice. So I'm going to have to differentiate the colors here. So what that means is I'm going to have to take out the ceiling completely and find a kind of wood that is going to really make that pop. I'm actually thinking jungle wood because the jungle wood inside of this series is a lot darker than most other Minecraft jungle woods. So I'm going to go grab some of that real quick. And we have locked the villagers in here currently. So we're trying to get them to be... Oh, and I can also show you this over here, which we did. I lined this path out, put some stairs going up and leading to our nether pocket. Until I get nether brick, it's not finished just yet, but we got nether rack, which I'm going to make move in the next few episodes. So stick with me on that. As for right now, the netherrack, it's sporadic throughout the little tunnel that we have going on inside of here until you reach the actual nether portal inside of the end when it becomes a lot more full. We're going to replace a lot of the stone that's on the outside with the nether brick itself so it kind of, you know, evolves into a room like that. And we're going to obviously have to give it a magnificent entrance. One way too big and out of proportion.
What episode is up to date right now?
We're almost on episode 50.
Up to date?
Yeah.
On the YouTube?
Oh, on YouTube it's like 36. I think we're like 14 or 15.
Who is this?
That is a newcomer, which I just invited to the series. Hi, our new friend. Here's our coordinates. -8 by -1800. It's a survival walk. So survive. You're like, who is this? We've been searching for some other members online, and I give them a little questionnaire to find out a little bit about them and see how things go. Oh, I was going back to get some jungle wood. And their walk, which you guys were with us on the first episode, I think I currently am the only person that has went on the walk from there to here without dying at the particular moment. We did have a newcomer that showed up, and they went on a little spree of deaths before they made it here. Everybody that pretty much joins inside of the realm has a little bit of a... of an issue getting inside of here. I don't know if that's, you know, just where we chose or whatever. And some people have a little bit of a disconnection issue, but that's more, I don't know what that is. So I'm looking for jungle wood. Junga. Get that junga. We'll place it instead of the granite there. Yeah. Pretty much. Some people it takes one try, others 10. It's like a test, but it wasn't meant that to be the... So. Probably less than me. How many did it take, Ace? Ask him. Going back up there. We were actually curious how many it took, Ace. I don't remember off the top of my head. Took Ace more than 5? Jeez. Okay, so we got that, and we were going to work with the jungle wood. Yeah, we're going to make some planks. Many planks, many planks. I don't even know why I put that in there.
You said you want me to design this side of the room?
Yeah, that room over there. That's the last room on that side. So
kumbaya,
you...
Kumbaya!
Kumbaya! Okay, so let's start off with some jungle wood. Jungle booty wood! So, thanks. Your version. If you want the latest version, I can send you a link as I update it weekly. Your version is about 2 weeks. No, maybe 3 weeks, actually. 3 weeks old. Do you know how to install text packs? Okay. So let's see how this looks. Okay. It's a darker wood for sure. I think Ace also uses mobile, so yeah, that looks good. I like the dark wood. He uses an Android?
I think so.
Is it a droid, my good sir? A droid. Oh, very good. Excellent. Also uses a droid.
You just leave it up to Ace.
Up to you, Ace! Ace is the man. He's like, what the heck, you douches. And tell him once he gets, I need to get back onto this, but tell him once he gets here, we have Discord info on the board and all that. We have realm rules. Okay, I think that wood actually looks very nice. I'm gonna do each side here and outline it. Yeah, if I just outline it, it's going to be very beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Games and NPC. Oh, I'm not reading off what he's saying. So we are on the edge right here. This is gonna look nice. This is gonna look very, very nice. I'm very excited to bring it. I think we're gonna have more than 38 though. So we're gonna bring it all the way around and see how that wood looks. From the side here, it's already looking really cool. Very dark. Got a very modern dark feel to it. I don't want to keep changing color, so I'd actually stick to this color for a little ways out until I reach the outside edge. Just tell him once he gets here and he reads the realm rules, then I'll have the link sent over to him. Okay, so we got some cobblestone back, and we need already some more junga.
You will send the link?
Yeah, a link to the most recent texture pack to the email that he's already provided, because I already have his email. Ja. There we go. Okay, so let's take a look. That ceiling is looking fine. Very good. And requests. Leave in Discord as check. Okay. So here we go. Should I have it around the bottom too? It's the rules board. You got here. Sorry, all I've been a little bit busy texting back and forth. You guys are like, dude, I am tired of watching you type things. Well, too bad. You're my series. Are you able to change the textures of mobs? Yes. Why would I change them? I like the pink creeper. Let's put them all around the outside here since we have the spruce. Don't I have an axe? I do have an axe. That would have made it way faster. You guys are like, man, Grave, you freaking spaz. Just use an axe, man. What?
Kumbaya.
Kumbaya.
We okay. have this inside joke where we sing that all the time. For fun. All the time. Before dinner, before bed.
Before dinner and before bed? That's not an inside joke. Anyone that's like really religious is probably like really upset at us right now. Like, how dare you make fun of that song? We're not making fun of the song, just the way that it sang. It's just funny.
Okay. I didn't even know about that song until you told me about it.
Yeah. Yeah, she didn't even think that it was a song when I started singing it once.
I didn't.
She was like, what is that? That's so stupid.
Jeez, no, I didn't. Not like that.
Alright, not that bad.
You're making me seem like the bad guy.
The bad guy? Yeah.
When you're really the one that's been bad.
When it was really me? Okay. So maybe... What am I thinking here? So I got the outsides. I got them lined. That looks cool. That looks cool. It's reversed. I don't know yet. I'll probably mix some of this spruce wood with a little bit of birch, as birch gives it actually coordinates with the spruce in this pack so far really well, as the birch gives different blocks that are a little bit lighter and a little bit darker, so it gives a little bit of versatility. Wait, should I be doing that? Or should I lift it back up, make jungle wood planks, and make it come out? Oh! My mind is wandering! So, I'm thinking that I'm... That's
dying.
One death! Oh! One down! Boo! To the death! So that's one. Let's try and make some of this jungle booty.
Jungle booty?
Uh-huh. Let's make that into planks. There we go. Let's make all this jungle booty into planks. Okay, now we don't even have any more jungle booty. Get out of here! So now we're gonna lift it up to match with that there. That, I think, is gonna be pretty cool. Maybe not with those torches right there, but... Yeah. Yeah, does that look cool? Okay. We're gonna line it up. Now bear with me here, because this time next episode, you guys are gonna end up looking at this place when it's finally done and go, that looks nothing like how you designed it, but right now it's not about how I designed it, because it's gonna be redesigned tons and tons and tons and tons of times. It's about how my process of designing works. Because the outcome is going to be beautiful. It's going to be so beautiful. This guy needs to get out of my way. I do not want to trade you, sir. I do not like what you have for me. Okay. Oh, no, that was a terrible placement. It's always nice when people say that. The texture pack that you have meshed together so far is beautiful. Because some of the textures that we have so far are borrowed from other texture packs, and other ones I've used other people's designs and changed and mixed and changed colors, and then I've created my own textures on my own. So far it's a mixture of everything. When it comes to the moving plants and everything, I took a different texture that was already there and started moving them around using between paint.net and Photoshop and all that fun kind of stuff to actually create my own fun little thing that's going on inside of the game. It definitely took some work. That is for sure. What do you say? Well, He's like, and so the ocean calls. Yes. Breathe that fresh, fresh ocean air. So far, Austin, I like you. You seem like a good guy. You've already made it to the ocean. Very proud of you. Very proud. Okay. So that looks nice. That looks neat. You like that so far?
Yeah.
It does. It looks pretty neat. This might, like, it didn't really turn out to be a penthouse suite so far. So we're going to have to make the his and hers bedrooms inside of there more like the penthouse suite. Right now, this is more of a restaurant for sure. So we are gonna run out of jungle wood, period. We are gonna have to cut down some jungle trees here soon. So there's two.
There's jungle wood inside of my wood chest.
Oh, you have jungle wood? Excellent.
There's not inside of the wood chest already. There's not?
I took the last of it. I have took the last of it. So, we have a couple new members. We went through all that. We went over what we've done last time. We've shown you a little bit what is inside of the works right here. Let me give you an update since we've done a little bit of work on this little restaurant suite thing going on here. And a couple villagers that have joined us inside of our prison. We are gonna take off on the outside up here, and I'm gonna show you what Blood Ace and Krabby have been working on their mob spawner down below. Now, we went over this inside of one of the last couple episodes here, but they've done a little bit of change, and the only thing that they did of change was adding a villager down here, which was just a super cool idea that I want you guys to check out that you may or may not have seen so far. They've been very hard at work at this. Every time that they log in, I swear these guys are always in here doing something inside of here, working on it just a little bit. And look, there's Ace right now, I believe.
He's always in there.
Working on it. He's just sitting there gaining levels. So that's the maintenance room right up there, which we've already showed you guys. The up spawner, down spawner off. Right there. And look, here is a clerk, which is a cleric. He's going to save you, or he's going to trade you 37 rotten flesh for an emerald. So you get all of your rotten flesh and emeralds out of these chests inside of here, which drop naturally from the mobs into droppers that drop into these boxes here. Then you just check the box out right there, and you have tons of rotten flesh that you trade to this guy for an emerald. Which is a fantastic trade. It should have been cheaper. And he will trade one emerald for two glowstone. Fantastic. So technically a half a stack of rotten flesh for a couple glowstone, which is the deal of a lifetime. So our friend Blood Ace right there is just going back and forth inside of the maintenance room. He is always working on this thing.
From one of the cart box.
What? He has a cart?
To the right.
Oh, I'll just walk. I'm talking to my friends online right now anyways. They don't talk back much, but I'm talking to them. So that is what our friend Blood Ace and Krabby have been doing, along with the Darkness Mob Spawner, which is a floating island above our city. Oh, he's almost here. Sweet. Are you going to go meet him?
Yeah.
So I've showed you the airport. It's not an airport, but what it is that dark room mob spawner that's up top, which we're going to be turning into a floating island. Should be really cool. So I'm now going to give this newcomer, our friend, light trial. I think that's what it's meant to say, light trial or light trail, one of the two. I'm going to give him a tour of the place as we have ran out of time anyways. What a coinkydink. So thank you so much for watching, and please like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe to this music gaming channel as we have a butthole ton of more music videos, nudes, and 6 forms of awesome entertainment for your viewing and listening body parts to one and to all. If you enjoy the music before and after the episode, please do us a favor and like, subscribe to our official web page, which is www.thestillwinter.org, as we give out free music once a month to our subscribers. Thank you so much. Stillwinter in, out.
In the world of yesterday, when the girls looked down on me, called me names like Super Flake, Wannabe, or what's his name, put me down, walked away, my face was just their way of laughing, right in front of me. When I thought of giving up, falling out, and doing drugs, put my head down to rest, went to sleep, that's when I met the perfect girl, small bird.